Book Nook with me, Thomas Bushell. Today, I'll be reading this really amazing book, Lucas the Spider in a Springtime Adventure, based on the character by Joshua Slice, written by George Eliot, illustrated by Sydney Hanson. My friends at Cartoonito asked me to make this read-along video. I think you're really going to enjoy this book, my friends. It was a beautiful spring morning. Sunlight filled Lucas the Spider's attic dormer. He stepped out of his tiny tent, yawned and stretched, then looked out the window. Whoa! Look at the pictures of Lucas's friends. Ooh, he said, I have an idea. I'm going to have an adventure. What do you think Lucas sees out the window? Lucas put on his backpack and explorer's hat and sang a little song. Today is the perfect day for an adventure because it's sunny and it's what I want to do. I'm bringing snacks in my trusty backpack and my harp and my hat are coming too. Whee! Lucas said and jumped out the attic window, which is what jumping spiders do. Can you pretend that you're jumping just like Lucas did? Lucas's legs were full of spring. As he jumped into the tulip garden, he sang, jumping in the garden on a great adventure. For lunch, I'll eat a raisin and a pumpkin seed or two. Maybe if I'm lucky, I'll find a special treasure. And if I meet a friend, I will sing about them too. Just then, Lucas spotted Arlo the owl mumbling and grumbling next to a bright yellow tulip. Good morning, Arlo, Lucas said. What's good about it? Arlo said. Let's all say good morning to Arlo. Good morning, Arlo. What do you think Arlo is grumbling about? My nest is ruined. See? Then let's make another, Lucas suggested. Arlo frowned. But how? Together, Lucas said. Lucas and Arlo collected sticks and grass. They then carried them up, up, up Arlo's tree to weave them into a new nest. While they worked, Lucas sang a silly song to lift his friend's spirits. What do you call a lobster in a top hat? I wouldn't know, because I've never ever seen that. Can a jumbo June bug dance inside a thimble? Probably not, because they're not so very nimble. Do you have a silly song you like to sing? Ta-da! Lucas said. Arlo's new nest was beautiful, and Arlo was very happy. That made Lucas happy too. Oh, that's a pretty nest! Lucas skipped along the garden path again, singing, I'm on an adventure, but I got distracted. I met a grumpy friend whose nest had gone kersplat. Now he's not so grumpy. In fact, he's kind of happy. And I'm happy too, because I helped him out with that. Lucas scampered up to a smiling frog in a funny hat. Maisie the bee was flopped down on top, her antenna drooping like wet noodles. Do you have a favourite hat? Good morning, Maisie, Lucas said. No, it isn't, Maisie said. I want to make a birthday song for my best friend, but I can't find the words. Maybe you and I can write the song, Lucas said. That's a kind offer, Lucas, Maisie said. But how? Together! Lucas plucked a lively little ditty on his harp and sang, Today is your birthday. May your wishes all come. He pointed to Maisie. True? She said. I couldn't ask for a better friend than you. She was catching on. I hope that we can fly around the world together. You are my best friend, and best friends are forever. Maisie sang nice and loud. The song made Maisie happy, and that made Lucas happy too. That's a nice song Lucas and Maisie made up together. Next, Lucas hopped from the smiling frog across a sea of beautiful green grass to sandbox land. I'm on an adventure, but I got distracted. That's the second time now, but I don't really mind. I helped a worried friend who said that she was tongue-tied. Now she's feeling better, and she told me I was kind. Lucas hopped and hopped. Then, at the sandbox, he stopped. Bodie the chameleon and Findley the fly were pacing back and forth. "Good afternoon, friends," Lucas said. "How can you say that?" Findley said. "Bodie and I spent all morning making a sandcastle, and now it's going to fall apart." "It's tragic," Bodie agreed. "So let's fix it," Lucas said. Findley and Bodie looked confused. "But how?" "Together." I wonder how Lucas is going to fix Findley and Bodie's sandcastle. Lucas carried water from the bird bath to the sandcastle. Again and again, he soaked the walls and towels while Findley and Bodie repaired them. While they worked, Lucas sang, "Dry crumbly sandcastle, falling to the ground. You need a drink if you want to stick around. Here's a teensy sip and another repeat. Sandcastle, sandcastle, now you're looking sweet." He used water. Have you ever made a sandcastle before? The sandcastle did look as good as new. Findley and Bodie were very happy, and Lucas was too. Now Lucas set out to reach the back of the lawn, but the sun was low in the sky. As he walked, he got slower and slower. Looks like Lucas is getting tired. Today's great adventure has not happened yet. I'm almost out of time and the sun's about to set. My friends needed help and they really couldn't wait. So I put off all my plans and now it's just too late. Lucas sighed and shambled sadly towards home. First he passed the sandcastle where Bodie was pretending to battle a leafy twig dragon. Lucas smiled, just a little. Then he passed Maisie. She was carrying a honey-soaked birthday cake and singing Happy B-Day to her best friend. Lucas sang too, just a little. Soon he came to Arlo's tree and looked up. There was Arlo, bouncing up and down in his new nest. Lucas couldn't help but bounce too, just a little. "Hi, Lucas," Findley called, flitting up beside him. "How was your day?" Lucas shrugged. "Before I helped you with your sandcastle, I wrote a song with Maisie, and I helped Arlo make a new nest." Findley buzzed happily. "Whoa," he said. "That sounds like quite an adventure." Lucas thought about that. "You know, Findley," he said after a moment, "I think it was." Then Lucas smiled, not just a little, a lot. That evening, Lucas snuggled inside his cozy bed. "Today, I didn't do all the things I thought I would. But guess what? I had a great adventure anyway. Helping all my friends really made me feel good. I think it was a perfect kind of day." And with that, Lucas yawned and fell asleep. Let's all say goodnight to Lucas. Goodnight, Lucas! Well, that's all for today, friends. Thank you for watching and I'll see you soon for our next Read Aloud. By the way, watch Lucas the Spider during Cartoonito on Cartoon Network.